four, three.
QuadJacks TV, sitting here with my new friend, old friend actually. Old
on Twitter.
Old on Twitter and Skype. Yeah. New in person. Yeah. Mazin Khoury, MSauce. Welcome. It's really great to see you. You look great, by the way.
I appreciate it. I do what I can.
You just did the news with us, and you know, I think we all needled you for being, you know, for the eating stuff. But you look very good. I'm very happy to see you. Mazin, tell us about. We're done flirting. Tell us. maybe we'll pick it back up. Tell us about your beginning in poker, and people call you MSauce. Like, where does that come from? A little bit.
It's weird, yeah. Beginning in poker.
Ciao.
I guess I started when I was actually a friend. I used to play a lot of tennis. I'm actually advertising for one of my old coaches. I don't know why. I used to play a lot of tennis, and one of my friends was like, "Hey, have you heard of this Full Tilt thing?" And I was like, "No, what's that?" And this was, I don't know, maybe in 2005 or 6 or something like
today,
that.
Today, that question carries a whole new meaning. Yeah, Have you heard of this Full Tilt thing?
I've heard there's something bad that's happening.
Okay.
And I was like, "No, I haven't." And he was like, "How about poker? Do you know anything about poker?" And I was like, "No." And he was like, "Well, check out this site. You can play for play chips."
You were in 2005. You were such a young man. You were a boy.
I was 16.
Wow.
Or whatever. All right. I mean, I might have even been a little bit younger when I first started. And so I started playing for play chips, and I thought it was fun. And actually, how I started playing for real money, I ran my play chip. You start with 1,000 play chips, and I got it up to like about 2 million or something like that, which at the time was tough because the highest they offered was 100, 200, but now they offer like, or they used to offer as high stakes as whatever. So I did that. I ran up to 2 million. I was really excited. So like I was happy, just content playing for that. And then one day I lost the whole 2 million in one day. And I was playing like 100K play chip sit-and-goes or something. I went a huge downswing and lost. And I was crushed. And like that's why I started playing poker for real money for like the total wrong reasons. At the time I was like, "Oh, I don't want to play with these people who don't care. That's why I'm losing, you know, when really you do want to play, you know," but I had the wrong, and I was like, so I started deposit, I made my first $50 deposit and started playing. And I busted that in an infinite amount of times, but eventually I found 2+2 and got better at poker. And
you know, your story is very similar to mine, like how I got into poker. I did the same thing. I watched poker on TV. I saw a Full Tilt being advertised. I started playing play chips. I thought it was fun, and then I was like converted. You know,
So the play chip model works, is the bottom line.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, it can. There's a big debate over, how do you convert people such. But it's good to know. Today you are, professional poker player.
Yeah.
You're here at the World Series. Yeah. And you came from Costa Rica. So this, you were playing, you said you were from North Carolina.
North Carolina. Well, I was Pittsburgh originally, but North Carolina for the last. Went to NC State.
Like, you're really, we've talked a lot about Black Friday here on QuadJacks, and you are really the kind of person, I think, the kind of player we talk about when we talk about the Black Friday's impact on the poker community.
Right.
You had to move.
Yeah.
Now, when did you make that decision, and did you really, and how much did you feel like this is what you had to do to continue to support yourself without having to change your career?
Well, yeah, I'm not really sure how quick I made the decision, but it was pretty fast. At first, we were all worried because we weren't sure. Luckily, I had all my money on poker stores, which is just such a huge blessing in retrospect. But we were all concerned as to when we were going to get the money. Not that we thought anything bad about the companies, but just how long is the Department of Justice going to hold the money up? How long, because I had at least 80% of my net worth on the site. So,
what about the play chips on Full Tilt? Like, did you get those back? Did you sell
play
those?
Play chips? No, I just lost all the play chips. But
go ahead.
Yeah, so I was at first I was concerned about that because I was like, well, if I don't get this money, I'm not going to be able to move anything until I do, because I didn't even have enough. I had enough money to go to school and live like that. But that's about it. And so once they paid those out, and I immediately took off to Vegas. I left really early. I was finished with school for that semester. I took off and went to Vegas. I had a good World Series, and then I was like, well, I definitely should move to continue because I really don't have anything else that I can do at home that will make anywhere near as much money or I'll have as much fun doing.
Right.
So that's when I decided, and I went straight from the World Series to Toronto.
Tell us, when and how poker refugees enter the picture.
Yeah, actually, my roommate who I was living in Toronto at the time was the one that found them. He's a big forum grinder, more so than I. And he came across this thing, and we were both. He had been in Canada for almost 6 months, and you know, as an American, you're only supposed to stay six out of the 12, and then you have to leave for the other six. So he was kind of looking for a new place to go. Winter was coming, and we're from North Carolina, so none of us wanted to be in Canada during the winter. So he said, there's this poker refugees thing. They relocate people to Costa Rica. Costa Rica sounds like fun. What do you think? And right. we contacted them, and they went from there.
It was a smooth move, a smooth transition.
Very smooth.
How were you liking it there?
I really love it, actually. I like it a lot more than I thought. At first, you know, there's the language barrier. I don't speak almost any Spanish. I made the mistake of taking French in high school.
Little too Costa Rican-y.
Yeah, and so, like, things were a little bit of a struggle early on, but really, I mean, that's why poker refugees was so valuable for us, because, like, we would have never been able to get our internet set up or, like, you know, talk to lawyers or open bank accounts or whatever. I mean, we would have just been...
You're helpless, Mazin.
Kind of clueless. So, I think... We maybe, if we spoke Spanish, right. maybe could have figured it out on our own, but not speaking Spanish,
I would expect that. I would think that, well, listen, moving to any other country, even one that's close, like Canada or Costa Rica,
right.
has to be difficult, especially if you're moving there to continue doing such an uncommon line
is,
of work,
that's
which
actually
is online.
Frowned upon in some countries too. So
yeah.
It makes it a little bit more difficult.
Like if you're going there to be, you know, a student, maybe okay, maybe maybe it's a reason. We play online poker. That seems like all right. So now you're here at the World Series. You just got in.
Yep.
How are you finding it? Like, how long have you been living in Costa Rica?
I think about 9 months.
Nine months. So now you're gonna put in the grind at the World Series.
Yeah, I'll be here, you know, for a month and a half or whatever. Or to about a month or something.
And
like
then you're
that.
Gonna go back
and
to
then,
Costa Rica.
I'm gonna go home, see the family and everything for a week or two, and then head back.
How was the patch being received? Are people asking about poker refugees?
You know, I didn't get any questions today, but
you just got here.
It was
too.
A super tough field,
That's
so
true.
None of them, like most of them, probably already know. You know what I mean? So I'm sure once we get into the more amateur player fields, people will say, "What's the name?"
Listen, I'll keep wearing it.
Yeah.
Okay.
You'll get some questions.
And listen, Mazin, good luck to you. I know you know you're gonna be playing here at the series. We'll be seeing
yep.
you.
I'll be around.
Hope to have you sit down with us again, update us, tell us more
Absolutely.
Costa Rican tales.
I'll let you know all the tournaments I've
stuff
busted.
Like that.
And how
Please,
I
no,
am.
No. If it, you know.
No, I fully plan on winning.
Nice. Thanks so much, Mazin. Good luck
Pleasure.
To you. Okay.
Thank you.
PokerRefugees.com. Yeah.